الآن مع كلمة المجموعة الآسيوية مع معالي السيد مولود جاويش أوغلو وزير خارجية جمهورية تركيا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. His Royal Highness Prince Khalid Al Faisal, Emir of Mecca, dear colleagues, Mr. Secretary General, Excellencies, brothers and sisters. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On behalf of my country and the Asian group, I would like to extend my sincere appreciation to Hadim al-Haramain Sharifain, King Salman bin Abdulaziz, for assuming the patronage of this event, and to His Royal Highness Prince Khalid Al Faisal, Emir of Mecca, as well as the Secretary General of the OIC, His Excellency, my brother Yusuf Al Otaymen, for organizing this meaningful event on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of our organization. I am glad to see the due implementation of the Turkish-Saudi co-sponsored resolution at the 46th Council of Foreign Ministers on the celebration of the 50th anniversary. Dear brothers and sisters, 50 years ago, our first Qibla, Al-Aqsa Mosque, returned from the brink of a disaster. A malign hand attempted to set on fire Masjid Al-Aqsa, severely damaging the member of the mosque. For the Muslim Ummah, this heinous attack was a wake-up call and achieved our long-desired goal of unity and solidarity to protect Al-Aqsa Mosque, Al-Quds Al-Sharif, and to defend the rights of the Palestinian people. I would like to pay tribute to the late King Faisal bin Abdulaziz Al Saud of Saudi Arabia and the late King Hassan II of Morocco for their call to Ummah to convene and unite in Rabat. Turkey and many Asian group members responded to this call without hesitation. Since the first OIC meeting in Rabat, we have consistently expressed our commitment to our important goal, the liberation of Al-Quds Al-Sharif, the end of Israeli occupation of all the Palestinian and Arab territories, and realization of undeniable rights of Palestinians for the establishment of an independent and sovereign Palestine state on the basis of 1967 borders with Al-Quds Al-Sharif as its capital. The Rabat Declaration reaffirmed our commitment to the principle of peace, but peace with honor and justice. Turkey and all the members of the Asian group countries have always remained loyal to the original founding goal of the OIC set half a century ago. Your Royal Highness, colleagues, brothers and sisters, our summit chairmanship between 2016 and 2009 came to a time when the Ummah faced grave challenges to our primary common cause. Unity and solidarity of Ummah were tested, and alhamdulillah, we have been able to keep our unity and resolve in tackling these challenges. The convening of special emergency sessions of the UN General Assembly on the status of Al-Quds and on the protection of Palestinian civilians are two tangible results we have achieved. It is the charter duty of our organization to protect the rights and the dignity of Muslim peoples, minorities and communities everywhere, including Rohingyas, Kashmiris, Uyghurs, Turkish Cypriots, Turkish minority in Western Thrace, and the Muslims in Europe and North America. On its part, Turkey has been active and vocal within the OIC to address these challenges. Protection of Muslim minorities and communities and combating Islamophobia are two of the interlinked issues that Turkey and Asia members attach importance. And I would like to express here my appreciation to Gambia for its leadership role in filing a case in the International Court of Justice on behalf of OIC in line with the decision of the 14th Islamic Summit held in Mecca under the chairmanship of King Salman bin Abdulaziz, we should support these efforts. In the face of increasing attacks against Islam and Muslims, we should be vigilant more than ever. Attacks in Christchurch and Oslo are one and same in its motives. I am glad that the Peace and Dialogue Contact Group, initiated and chaired by Indonesia, has already adopted a plan of action on combating Islamophobia. We are also working with Malaysia and Pakistan on a joint TV to fight Islamophobia. At the OIC family, as a great family, biggest, one of the biggest family in the world, throughout our term as chair of the Islamic Summit, we generated more than 30 high-level meetings along with the new initiatives, new mechanisms, and countless rewarding outcomes. Your Royal Highness, brothers and sisters, the Palestinian cause remains our most significant agenda. We have been able to unite our efforts to react and grave Israeli violations, and which actually grew reckless with the unconditional backing of the United States administration at the cost of international law. We have to be steadfast and persistent to end the Israel occupation and achieve the independent and sovereign state of Palestine. From a little child who marches for freedom and dignity on the streets of Gaza, to men and women of Al-Quds resisting the occupation, I salute brave men and women who are standing up against the apartheid and inhuman isolation of Palestinians. We hear your voice. Hundreds of millions of Muslims are with you. Dear colleagues, brothers and sisters, the 50th anniversary offers an opportunity to reflect not only our achievements, but also on issues that we missed. Unfortunately, the Ummah is still divided for various reasons. Sectarian or ethnic conflicts are commonplace. Most of the global conflicts are on our geographies. We even have divisions on issues of core interest. That said, we are proud of the achievements of the second largest international organization in the world. Despite our diversities, we have achieved unity in actions and on many various issues. We believe that our religion's basic messages of peace, unity and solidarity will help us resolve existing problems among us. Here today in Jeddah, in the holy region of Mecca, we are celebrating the 50th year of our unity, solidarity and cooperation as one great family. I thank the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia for hosting the headquarters of OIC. Before I conclude, I wish success to the Summit Chair Saudi Arabia, Council of Foreign Ministers Chair United Arab Emirates, and the Secretary General to in carrying the OIC forward. Rest assured that Turkey and the ASEAN Group members will continue to support you in your endeavors for Palestine and the well-being of whole Ummah. Let me conclude by praying Allah Almighty that for one day we all can come together in this sovereign and independent Palestine, in the city of Al-Quds, to celebrate the next anniversaries of our organization. Amen. Thank you very much. Okay.